How can you have confidence in somebody who leaks official documents, thereby undermining best practice and the standards of public office? Can I call it a predictable row at 2 o'clock today over the order of business and the move to the convention centre should also have been avoided? And as I said in the Dáil chamber, there was no reason why the government couldn't have put forward their motion to be taken tomorrow when we'd already be here, and therefore we could have avoided the cost of actually moving down here in this basis. Ken Corda, I was reading the Department of Public Expenditure and Reform circular entitled Policy on the Use of Private Email and Other Private Messaging Services, which was sent around by HR in April 2019. The circular related to the use of services other than official or active designated modes of communication. It states that it relates to civil servants, but surely the question here is that a Tánaiste and Minister's ability to carry out his official government position to the highest standard must also mean that he is at very least held to the same standards as our government and departmental officials. The circular even allows for exemptions to the rule, but says that information relating to government business must be forwarded to official work accounts prior to being deleted. Point 12 states, failure to adhere to the requirements set out in the circular may result in disciplinary action under the Civil Service Disciplinary Code. Why do Fianna Fáil, Fine Gael and the Greens think that the Tánaiste, Minister for Enterprise, Trade and Employment, is above the standards we set for our civil servants? We are civil servants, Ceann, and we should be held accountable for our actions. It appears to me that the Tánaiste actively deleted his account rather than forward the messages to the official account. And as far as I can see from looking at WhatsApp, you have to actively delete an account on that messaging service. You cannot do it by accident, and it doesn't happen automatically either. So the Tánaiste could simply apologise and step down, as the previous Tánaiste, Frances Fitzgerald, did. And there is no excuse for Fianna Fáil and the Green Party TDs to be saying that they have confidence in the Tánaiste. He undermined best practices for standards in public office. This much he has admitted himself. And now he should face the consequences of those actions. If the Tánaiste thinks that welfare cheats cheat us all, what does he think about politicians who behave as if they are above the standards set for others and others in the civil service? Who is cheated then, Ceann Corda? Because I would definitely say that the electorate has cheated, as well as cheating those of us, the elected representatives, who try to earn the public's trust in politics.